And George Bilecki joins me now. And George, a pretty special Rose Bowl for Scott Nelson.
That's right, because he shared that moment with his brother coming off his junior year as a Badger. And that was when Wisconsin suffered their 8th straight losing season. So to be playing in the game his senior year and then have a 21-16 win over UCLA in the Rose Bowl was shocking enough. But for Scott, it was just the beginning to a lifetime of memories.
We were hungry. We were tired of being kicked around. And so guys were ready to go.
The Wisconsin Badgers have defeated the UCLA Bruins by a score of 21-16.
We did something that had never been done before. Teams have been out to the Rose Bowl, but we hadn't won. And we got over that hump.
That Rose Bowl victory capped off a 10-1 season and laid the foundation for what Wisconsin football is today.
When you start thinking back about what that all was, how special it was to us as players, and then to people that have waited a lifetime to see this happen, to have it come true, it was pretty special.
Now, Scott Nelson of Sun Prairie witnessed just 11 wins during his first 3 seasons as a Badger. But ending his career with the Rose Bowl victory was just the beginning.
After the game, you celebrate with your teammates. We're doing some interviews, and I might have about 4 or 5 guys around me finish up the interview, and I see her there. Holy cow, I gotta regroup again.
The 3-hour battle against the Bruins was behind him, but Scott quickly had to shift his focus to his girlfriend, Becky.
She just came over and I had been hurt earlier in the game. She thought it was something along the lines of that. And I said, no, I'm fine. Just gave her a hug. And as I gave her a hug, this good friend of mine walks by and hands me the ring. You're excited, your tears from winning the game, and then to be able to pop the question, drop down on the knee. We got a great picture of her with her mouth wide open, shocked. And thankfully, she said yes.
The Rose Bowl has meant so much to the Nelsons. And now, a quarter century later, Scott and Becky are going back. But this time, as parents of walk-on wide receiver Cooper Nelson.
We wouldn't trade it. Both my wife and I wouldn't trade what we have.
It's the next chapter in the family story that stretches from Madison to Pasadena. And as Scott gets to share this experience with his son, the advice he passes down is simple.
I said, take it all in. Everything that you're doing now, watching Jonathan Taylor, one of the greatest running backs to play, soak it in. See how he performs. How does he prepare? Get out to California, having the California Highway Patrolmen on their motorcycles escorting you everywhere. That just doesn't happen in real life. So look around. When you get onto Camp Randall, look around. There's nothing better than coming out of that tunnel, except maybe out in Pasadena at the Rose Bowl.
Now, Cooper is a walk-on redshirt freshman wide receiver for the Badgers, so he won't be fully suiting up and playing in the Rose Bowl when the Badgers take on Oregon. But you know, when he stepped out on the field for the first time, he knew how special it was, not just to be in Pasadena, but of course to be a part and share something with his parents.
It's kind of surreal for me. I didn't really realize how special a place it is and can be. And then when I got here, pretty special place for our family. My dad's final game as a Badger, where my parents first started their future together, and I get to play here as my first bowl game, so that's pretty exciting.
Now, the advice that Scott shared with Cooper, it was the same as what he said there in the piece. He just kept it simple. Cooper told me the same thing. Just, hey, enjoy the ride.
Enjoy the ride. That's what we are doing here. That's George Bilecki. I'm Mike Jacks live in Pasadena. We'll have more coming up later in sports.